Good morning. I think we might have some announcements. How's everybody doing? Happy to see this lovely sunny Sunday morning. I'm going to turn this over to Alice and Althea, as David calls them, the A-team.
Good morning. If you want more details or if you missed some of these announcements and you want to get the details on them, they are on the website, the email blast, or the Facebook event page. First of all, if you have not already done so, please consider participating in our pledge program to raise funds to support hiring Kim Belew as our part-time Unity spiritual leader. Thus far, $12,000 has been raised, and our ultimate goal is $48,000, but we cannot start the contract process until we get to $24,000, so please, the cards are available in the back of the sanctuary.
Galleria of Grace gift shop. They are open and stocked with lots of wonderful items. And they are open today at the service until 1 o'clock. You make a right out the door and a right down the hall, and they're the second door on your left.
And this is the last day, I repeat, last day for the Lighthouse Youth and Family Services collection that we're doing. New Thought Unity Center is collecting school supplies for the benefit of the Lighthouse Youth and Family Services. Again this year, all donations can be placed in the Lighthouse bin in Friendship Hall, or as you see, most of them are up here on the platform. And if you haven't gone shopping and you'd like to donate to that, you can feel free to leave us a check and we'll make sure that it gets to the Lighthouse.
Angel's Wings Resale Shop. There's an August sale going on. All clothing is a dollar each per piece, or you can do a $5 bag. Shoes are $2 a pair. Purses are $2 each. The shop is open Friday 10 to 2, Saturday 10 to 4, and today noon until 3. So buy.
And you can awaken the mastermind consciousness that is facilitated by Alice Frazier. It's Wednesday, September the 7th. September 7th?
Yeah, that's what it says.
That's the next one, I guess, isn't it? At 6:30 in Friendship Hall, check the email blast or contact the center.
Crossport. Crossport meets the second and fourth Mondays at 7:30 p.m. in person or via Zoom. You can contact Lauren Watson or the center for more information.
Women and Wisdom, Saturday, August the 20th, from 10 to noon. Our guest speaker this month is David McClanahan, who will talk about joyous spirituality. As always, all genders are welcome, and there is a $10 love offering. Make sure you use the Zoom link to pre-register for this gathering using the link provided.
New Thought Unity Center Picnic. August the 21st, immediately following our service. Please make sure you let us know if you are planning on going to the picnic and what dish you would like to bring. Call the center to RSVP, and there's a sign-up sheet out in the foyer that you can sign up on also. Nancy needs to know how many people to prepare for, and we need to know how much meat we need also. So thank you for signing up for the picnic.
Karaoke. Our next karaoke night, in case you missed it this Friday, is September the 2nd, 7 o'clock in Friendship Hall. Join karaoke with Kim for an evening of special song. Bring your snacks, drinks, and your voice. And don't forget to put a little something in the tip jar for DJ Kim.
Are there any anniversaries and birthdays this month? Please stand so we can recognize you and honor you. Birthdays and anniversaries.
Oh, man, look at that. What a special Sunday it must be.
God is blessing you now. God is blessing you now. God is blessing you. You are wonderful. God is blessing you now.
Happy
happy birthday and happy anniversary.
And please join us after the service down in Friendship Hall, where we can get to know each other a little bit better for a snack and coffee. Or tea.
Let's sing some music. Let's sing a song. How's that?
You might know this one. If you do, just feel free to sing with us.
People get ready. There's a train a-coming. You don't need no baggage. You just get on board. All you need is faith to hear the diesels humming. You don't need no ticket. You just thank the Lord. So people get ready for the train to Jordan, picking up passengers coast to coast. Faith is the key. Open the doors and board them. There's hope for all among those love the most. There's even room for the whole. Just to save his own. Have pity on those whose chances grow thinner. There's no hiding place against the kingdom's throne. People get ready. There's a train a-coming. You don't need no baggage. You just get on.
Wonderful. Already feeling the Spirit moving through us and in this place. Good morning again.
Good morning.
We want to welcome Reverend George Whitton up to say good morning. You might have an affirmation.
I just might have an affirmation. Good to be here this morning. Our affirmation for today is, I discover and express the joy that is within me. I discover and express the joy that is within me. Could we affirm that together? I discover and express the joy that is within me. And why don't we just take a moment and maybe close our eyes and just take that thought within. There are many happy experiences and memory that may lead us to feeling joyful. But we've come to know that they are not the source of our joy. As one of our divine gifts, joy is part of our spiritual identity, as close to us as our breath. Joy is always present and resides in our hearts. The happiness that we feel in life depends on our allowing our inner wellspring of joy to come from within and express through us. An attitude of gratitude and an appreciation for the gift of life supports us in maintaining and experience a life of joy. And so as we go into the world grateful for the ability to share our birthright of joy, we bless others and truly we bless ourselves. And for that good that is here and for the joy that is here, truly we are blessed and we say thank you. And amen.
Wonderful. Thank you, George. Now it's time for us to stand and sing our congregational together. Yeah.
There was a time in my life I thought I had to do it all by myself. I didn't know the
sufficient. I didn't know the love of God was at hand. But now I can say, if you are discouraged, struggling just to make it through another day, you've got, I said you've got to let it go. Just let it all go. And this is what you had to say.
I release and I let go. I let the Spirit run my life. And my heart is open wide. Yes, I'm only here for God. No more struggle, no more strife. With my faith I see the light. I am
with us.
I release and I let go. I let the Spirit run my life, and my heart is open wide. Yes, I'm only here for God. No more struggle, no more strife. With my faith I see the light. I am free in the Spirit. Yes, I'm only.
Now's the time when we can meet and greet each other with a handshake or a hug.
And if you would, say with me our mission and vision statements. Our mission statement is, in God, we are an inclusive, abundant community, experiencing love, transforming lives, and serving others. And our vision statement is, we celebrate a world of harmony and oneness, a place of loving stewardship, sacred connections, and pure joy, where all are welcomed with honor and respect. And what we want you to know about us more than anything is that wherever you are on your spiritual path, wherever you've been, wherever you think you're going, you're welcome here. If this is your first time here, in the back corner we have a newcomer's table. There is a packet of information with a gift from us, and Regina will be back there after the service, and she can answer any questions that you may have about the center. So again, thank you so much for being with us this morning. And now we're going to ready ourselves for meditation.
Let's prepare ourselves for an experience of the gift of joy. In an easy and relaxed manner, in a healthy and positive way, we take these moments of prayer to breathe in an air of calm. In our imaginations and in reality, we fill our lungs, our bodies, and our minds with a refreshing breath of joy, compassion, and peace. For just a few moments, we take time to gently and easily release worry, strain, and concern of the outer world so that we may focus our entire being in prayerful unity. We automatically let go of any darkness simply by focusing on our inner light of goodness. We let it be that easy. From our center, we allow the love that we are to well up and wash over us, filling us with comfort and joy. This puts a smile on our faces because we are aligning with and acting from our true nature, our spiritual nature. We are made in the image and likeness of God, in the image and likeness of goodness. So we are good. We are goodness. As we align with our true nature, with the goodness we are, and as we express the goodness we are, we experience joy. Imagine what a wonderful place the world would be if everyone lived from the center of their beings. How do we do this? Let us look inward to our divine nature and find answers to these questions. What do I truly want? How do I go about getting it? And what do I want to give? Can we begin to imagine the endless flow of love that would pass from heart to heart if we did this? If we aligned with and lived the goodness we are. Each day, we can choose to experience heaven on earth by expressing our own unique form of goodness. Let us rest in these thoughts for a few moments in the silence. Let's affirm these closing thoughts for ourselves and each other. I am a being of goodness. Just say that with me softly. I am a being of goodness. That is my true, whole, one and only nature. As I express that goodness, I play my part in creating a wonderful world for myself, for ourselves, and each other. That's the only way it happens. As I say yes to a life of goodness, I experience joy and fill the world with joy. We are blessed, and we are a blessing. And for that understanding and for that experience, we say thank you. thank you. I am so grateful. Amen.
Haven't you noticed the patterns of the pain in your past? The things that broke you, they also woke you to the questions you needed to ask. The sleepless nights and the dizzying heights and the dreams, some of which came true. Tough breaks, heartaches, perfect mistakes created this version of you. And everything you go through grows you, and everything you go Peg. If it hurt, it made you softer. If it was hard, it fueled the hunger. If it touched you, your heart took hold. If it was simple, it made you wise. If it was sweet, it made you smile. Weaved an indelible impression on your soul. Feet they walked, and your lips they talked, and your hands dug around for the proof. Every nook, every book, picture in your mind that you took, created this version of you. And everything you go grows you, and everything you go through grows you, exposes the roots of an endless summer, part-time temporary lovers in the swoon of the deep blue sky. And as the time flew, you planted and gathered your truth as it passed before your eyes. And the wound is where the light gets in. revealing the masterpiece just beneath the skin. And in the glow of your own light, your petals open wide, and you bloom right where you are. And everything you go through grows you, grows you. And everything you go through grows you, exposes who you are. No mud, no lotus. Haven't you noticed the patterns of the pain in your past? Things that broke you, they also woke you to the questions you needed to ask. Please welcome George Whitton.
Good morning. Let's try it again. Good morning. But I like to hear. Always good to be here at the New Thought Unity Center. I always like to think, how you all doing? That's what we say in Burlington, you know. How you all doing? Sounds like you're doing great. Well, it's August. School year's about ready to start. Maybe in some circles it's already started. And I love hearing kids' comments about school. And so I've got a couple of them I want to share as we get started this morning. Sylvia says to her dad, "Dad, can you write in the dark?" And her dad thinks for a minute. He said, "Yep, well, I guess so. Why do you ask?" And she said, "Well, I've got a report card that needs signing." A teacher says, "I've got this 6-foot snake, and I have it in a box, and in this box, I've got this snake, 6 feet. Well, Sammy raises his hand. "Teacher?" "Yes, Sammy." "You can't fool me. Snakes don't have feet." Got to think about that one. Teacher says, "If I have 6 oranges in one hand and 7 oranges in the other hand, what do I have?" Joey says, "You got really big hands, teacher." Well, this morning, we're going to be talking about joy. Removing the blocks to the expression of joy. Now, if there's anyone here that doesn't care much about living a joyful life, please see me after class, okay? Because we need to talk a little. A number of years ago, Nancy and her mother, Dolly, and myself, we went to a concert. It was a Patsy Cline concert. And it was held at the local Boone County Library. And there we heard a singer. Patsy Cline had already transitioned. I'm not that old. We heard a singer named Teresa Dunn, and she sang lots of Patsy Cline songs. And Teresa Dunn's voice was just a spot-on match for Patsy's voice, and we really enjoyed that concert. But it was what she shared between the songs that reminded me so much about today's lesson. She said that after her father passed, she went into a depression. and it lasted for years. She went into therapy, worked with a therapist for a long time. Nothing ever helped. She was still depressed. And then one day, while listening to Patsy Cline, she shifted. And she went from being in a funk to being happy, to embracing life. She began expressing her joy through her music, and her life really did transform. So like Teresa Dunn, I think, sometimes our joy is obstructed from our view. It's obstructed by our thinking, which creates the point of view that we all have. Sometimes our thinking is kind of like closing the blinds on a picture window. We just seem to close ourselves in. The light is still there, but we can't see it. And you know what? I think joy is a lot like that. Many of us have spent a lifetime wishing and hoping that we could create a life of joy. But you see, joy does not need to be created. What? Let me say it again. Joy does not need to be created. Why would I say a thing like that? Well, I would say a thing like that because joy already exists. We don't have to create it. That's what transformation is all about, I think. It's removing the block so that we can express the joy that's within us, that's part of our birthright, that's already present. Each one of us has been created in the image and likeness of the divine. We've inherited the divine birthright of joy, and it is our part of our beingness, part of our essence of who we are. So what is blocking our joy is not the absence of money or prestige or lots of stuff. Our obstacles are those insecure parts of ourselves, insecure parts of our personality that need the stuff in order to feel safe and secure. These are the blinds and the curtains that block our joy from our everyday experience. And so our mission, if we choose to accept it, is to go about removing those blocks to our joy. Doing so will open up a window to our souls so that we might allow the joy of God that's already there to express in and through us and out into the world. Most of us are familiar with the work of Michelangelo, are we not? His most famous work is the 7-foot-high statue of David. David with a sling in one hand and a stone in the other. But how did it come into being? We usually don't think about it. Like all of us, especially those artists out that are here today, Michelangelo was able to see David in that stone when it was just a huge block of marble. He could see it. Way before he ever picked up a hammer and a chisel, he could see it. His mission was to begin chipping away, if you will, at that stone that was not David. Think about that. Chipped away at the stone that wasn't David, to free that magnificent statue that was hidden from his physical view. And so the question I have for each one of us today, including me, are you, am I, willing to see the magnificent image that is already present within you? It's already there. Now, some might say, magnificence in me? Are you sure? Yeah, I'm sure. I don't care about your past. I don't care about your story. We've all got one. And I don't care if you have less than maybe a stellar opinion of yourself. Not necessary. What's necessary is to know that there is a magnificent essence in each one of you, you especially. It seems like I've read somewhere that each of us has been created in the image and likeness of the divine. Now, this may be contrary to how we were raised. Maybe some of us were raised being told that we were evil. Maybe we were told that we were sinful, original sin. You know, original sin really didn't come about until the Council of Nicaea in about 325. Up until then, there wasn't any such thing. But good old Saint Augustine invented it for us, so that even if you were a good person, somehow you had to overcome original sin. How many of you had the opportunity to hold a newborn baby in your arms? How many of you had that opportunity? Nothing like it. When I looked at my newborn child, my daughter Elizabeth, I can't tell you. It brought tears to my eyes. It's bringing tears to my eyes right now, just thinking about it. And guess what I was not thinking? I wasn't thinking, you are sinful. How can anybody look at a newborn and think their essence is sinful? I don't get it. You know, as we begin our human journey, as best I can tell, that on this human journey, we sometimes have challenges. Anybody notice that? If not, see me after class. No lack of challenging experiences out there. We've all had them. So that's the bad news. Now, the good news, I think, is when we have those kinds of experiences, it presents one of those hot dog opportunities. We just need to start chipping away. Start chipping away at those parts of us that don't serve us, those parts of us that cause us not to feel whole and complete, cause us to feel somehow less than. But if we keep chipping away, if we persist, the magnificent image that is hidden within ourselves will eventually be revealed. The beauty that Michelangelo saw in that marble, he could unfortunately never see in himself. I don't know if you know his story. But he was an angry man. He wrote in a letter, and he said, I have no friends, nor do I want any. What a shame. Paradoxically, the beauty that he saw in that marble existed in that marble, and he could see it. Unfortunately, he could never see that magnificence in himself. He just couldn't see it. Never able to share the beauty that was within himself. Anger and resentment, this is probably no news, but anger and resentment do not yield joy. Anger and resentment yield anger and resentment. What we think about, we tend to bring about. But we don't have to condemn Michelangelo. We also sometimes choose fear or anger for ourselves instead of joy. It's part of the human experience. Dr. Jerry Jampolsky even wrote a book, a small little book about it years ago, and it's called Love is Letting Go of Fear. I'm sure some of you have read it. The fear choice is not always apparent, but it is a choice that we sometimes make. So what do we have to do? What do we have to do to wake up to the beauty that is residing within ourselves? I think the first thing we have to do is we have to realize that no matter what appearances may be currently, there is another possibility available to us. there is a joy-filled possibility. Would you affirm that with me? There is a joy-filled possibility. I believe that. But back to the sculpture. The discontented parts of ourselves, our fears, our upsets, our anger, our resentments, all that stuff can be there for a good percentage of our lives. But the loving parts of our personality, I will call it for this morning, our joy may be hidden. Hidden by those angry parts that we've been dealing with most of our lives. Those loving parts, those joy-filled parts, haven't gone away. They're still there. They remained imprisoned within ourselves until we free them. Now, our personality, the personality of humankind, keeps wanting to feel superior in some way. I think we feel superior so we can mask our insecurities. Judging others is a very common thing to do. Somehow if we judge them as less than, then we somehow think that we're elevated. But it's not really how it works. It's when we're able to shift our focus from our personality to our essence that we naturally, I say naturally because it's part of our nature, begin to express more love and more joy. When us guys long for that new car, or you ladies enjoy getting a new pair of shoes, nothing wrong with any of that. But when we do that, we get an instant fix. It feels good. We feel wonderful when we get those things. Thoughts of unworthiness and lack just seem to disappear. And this makes us happy. I'm all for happy. We feel relieved. But unfortunately, that kind of happiness that's outer directed, it just doesn't last. When we look to find happiness in the outer, it will eventually begin to fade. Why? Because in the external world, the longer that we're at the effect of something, well, the less we're going to be at the effect of it as time marches on. When our happiness depends on what happens outside of ourselves, it's going to be a challenge. The frightened and needy parts of our personality are forever trying to control what happens. And this is the constant pull of pursuing happiness by our ego, if you will, by our ego personality. On the other hand, when the loving parts of our personality exude being grateful, when we focus on being patient, when we are appreciative and really are grateful for the things that we are being blessed by in our lives, we feel content. When we're caring and extend ourselves to others, the joy that's within us begins to bubble up and come out. That's how we experience our joy. Joy doesn't require anything more than being able to appreciate this precious, precious present. The awe of a sunset, a gorgeous sunrise, the beauty of nature. Beautiful this time of year, isn't it? All connect us with the healing joy at our core. The joy we feel when we experience the tenderness of a touch, the warmth of a smile, and those experiences, none of those kinds of experiences are affected by want or I need. Just doesn't happen. And did you notice that all of these experiences that I've been talking about in the last minute, they're free. They don't cost a dime. I think there's a song that says something like that, that the best things in life are free, and I truly believe that. Joy is being grateful to be alive. once a long time ago, we went to a restaurant, and the waitress walked up, and I said, "How you doing today?" And she said, "I can't think of one thing to be happy about." And I said, "Really?" I should have kept my mouth shut, but it's not my nature. And I said, "Well, I can think of one thing you could be happy about." "What?" And I said, "You woke up. You woke up." Just knowing that we have the opportunity to participate in life is plenty to be joyful about. Plenty. Spiritual law says that wherever we place our attention, wherever we place our energy, it expands. The more we focus on the good in our lives, the more joy that we're going to create, the more joy we're going to have in our daily experience, the more we connect with the joy that's at our core, and the more we share that joy with others, the more we're going to experience a joy-filled life. Like Michelangelo, we too are sculptors. We're chipping away at those parts of us that don't serve us. And when we chip away what isn't serving us, we're going to create a life of joy. I am sculpting a life of joy. Would you affirm that with me? I am sculpting a life of joy. And so you are. It's been a pleasure being with you this morning. God bless you.
Thank you, Reverend George and Nancy, for being here. Give them another hand. Thank you so much. And you might notice that David Kaiser is not here. He had hernia surgery on Thursday and is recovering well. And so thank you, Mike Barrett, for sitting in on the keyboard today. Thank you, Randy, Peg, Jenny, Althea, and Alice. Everybody in the booth making us sound good and hopefully look good and all of that. The visuals, thank you so much. Now let's have some fun. There you go. Ready when you are. He needs a counter. As we roll down this unfamiliar road, although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone. So I'm gonna make this place your home. Come on, settle down. Trouble, it might drag you down. If you get lost, you can always be found. Just know you're not alone. So I'm gonna make this place your home. Come on, let's start with the ooh. Ready? Ah, joy?
Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear.
That's right.
And trouble, it might drag you down. If you get lost, you can always be found. Just know you're not alone. So I'm gonna make this place your home.
You feel joy, get on your feet. Come on, here we go. So much joy. Woo! We didn't want it to end. Yeah.
Thank
awesome.
You. Please
Thank
be
you so
seated.
Much.
Well, this is that time in our service where we say our offertory blessing and bless our tithes and our offering. So if you will, repeat it with me. Divine love moving in and through me blesses and multiplies all that I give and all that I receive. In our prayer chaplains today are Lauren and Marilyn, and they'll be over here at the prayer shawl after service to pray with you. We have chaplains online that hold sacred space for us during service as well as us here and after service. So see a prayer chaplain for a prayer request. Also in the back of the pews, there are prayer request cards. If you like to leave a prayer request, just fill one out and put it in the prayer box in the back of the sanctuary.
We have a few comments from people online. Brenda Zeckmeister says, warm greetings from Sunny Lake, Ontario, New York. James McLean, good morning and blessings from my new NTUC family. Teresa Villarreal, good morning NTUC from Rockford, Illinois. And Maria Salser, love and hugs from Maria and Jesse. Thank you for being with us online.
Well, loving spirit, we are so grateful today. Grateful to make a joyful noise into the world. We're grateful for these gifts given in love and given in joy. And for the good that's here, for the good that's everywhere, and for the joy that is part of our being, truly we are grateful and we say thank you and amen.
Well, we want to say thank you once again to Reverend George and Nancy for being here, to the band, the singers, and to all of you, everyone that watched online, everyone that's here. Now we can stand, find a hand to hold, say our prayer for protection and our peace song. Wow, we got a nice group here. We might be able to make a circle. Be pretty close. I think I can. Can do it. We can at least make a horseshoe. Horseshoes are nice. Bring us some good luck and some joy. Stretch it out. Connect those hands right there, and we'll have our horseshoe. Dun 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 dun. Yeah! All right. Now let's say together our prayer for protection.
The light of God surrounds me. The love of God enfolds me. The power of God protects me. The presence of God watches over me. Wherever I am, God is, and all is well.
Thank you.